Welcome back to New Day Cleveland. I am getting Neil Zurcher drunk. Now we are going on a ghost walk.
Okay, this is a perfect Halloween one tank trip. Neil Zurcher is here. He's trying to drink. What do you think?
I may not care about the rest of the show. Ooh, how much booze
did
you put in this?
A whole bottle.
Oh my God.
But it needed it.
A whole bottle.
It needed it.
This whole bottle. Is to give out to kids?
No. Oh, you can make it in a non-alcoholic way. It's a non-alcoholic drink that I added alcohol to. So you can do it either way.
You're gonna put this back in the green room?
Yes, so you can
the
have
guests
someone
are going to have a great time back there.
I like that he asked the question if you're going to give it to kids. That was great.
People are going to be dancing back there.
No, that's excellent. Your parents would be very unhappy with me. You're okay? You want me to hold that while you
No, I'm fine. No,
oh, you're
no,
good.
No.
You're good, okay. All right.
So anyway, you're saying on this one tank trip, you shouldn't drink one of these before you go, maybe while
well,
you're there.
You'll see ghosts if you do, believe me. Especially after this one. Natalie, you make a heck of a drink here.
She's a champion.
You believe in ghosts?
I do. Mm-hmm.
We're going to go to Ohio's most haunted town today, and it's our one tank trip.
Okay.
It's about 230 miles to southwest Ohio and the village of Waynesville. You know, for Waynesville, Ohio can be a small town, but it's also known for its antiques, it's known for a sauerkraut festival, and even as being the most haunted village in Ohio. Linda, why is this known as the most haunted village in Ohio?
Well, I think there's a long tradition of people telling ghost stories and not afraid to talk about what has happened or they've seen. We just found so many more stories that people were willing to share that was really very interesting.
Ghosts and ghost hunting have become big business in Ohio and across the country, with communities cashing in on their tales of spooks and strange happenings. Here in Waynesville, perhaps the most haunted place is a local inn and restaurant called the Hamel House. Owner Pam Bowman explains.
Our bed and breakfast guests tell us the same stories year after year, time after time, that a shadow in room 4 will come out of the bathroom. It's nothing menacing or extremely frightening. It'll just come out of the bathroom, go through the door.
A shadow like a human?
Uh-huh, it's a shadow of a man.
A man?
Uh-huh.
But you know, there are some other spots in this town that have some equally scary stories for the tourists. It makes them stop, look, listen, and maybe even shiver a little bit. Linda, why is the Stetson House supposedly haunted?
Well, John Stetson's sister, Larissa Lyric, passed away in the upstairs bedroom. And people have gone in there more than several occasions and experienced a strange happening. One woman that we know personally had someone touch her on the back of the neck, and there was no one else in the room.
No.
She will not go back in there. We have another lady that was on one of our tours that said that she and her sisters and her mother were up there when on a hot August day and a cold breeze went all through them at the same time. It was very scary, and they rushed out of the building and ran out into the street, and the clerk in the store followed them.
Waynesville, which was founded in 1797, was located halfway between Springfield and Cincinnati. There are an estimated 200 of the early buildings still standing, including the early Quaker Meeting House, which is now a museum, also allegedly haunted.
Several people were walking on the sidewalk by the museum, and they looked up and they saw a little girl in an old-fashioned white dress with a white hair bow standing on the front porch. They walked on a few steps, looked back, and the little girl was gone. There was no one here. But since then, she has been reported upstairs in the children's room several times, and our paravision people who come in and do studies have actually communicated with her.
Throughout the month of October, there will be nightly tours of Main Street in Quaker Hill. Contact the Waynesville Chamber of Commerce for a list of the evenings and details. It's October, and it's a time for Halloween and hobgoblins and things that go bump in the night. And if you like to be frightened, well, head for Waynesville, Ohio. You can have a real haunting experience. It's a great place for a one-tank trip. I'm Neil Zurcher. Remember, AAA will help you find the way. Do you ever have anything bump in the night?
Yeah.
I mean ghosts.
Have you been drinking too?
Well, I had a few small sips.
We're having a party today.
This actually looks like me a little bit. I mean, I was looking at that ghost there. I mean, it's.
So would you recommend having a couple of Natalie's drinks before?
Oh, absolutely.
You got to take this away from him.
If you're going to go on a ghost walk, I mean, if you don't believe in them to start with, yeah. Man, a couple of these and you'd see ghosts all night long.
And you know, and even if you don't believe in ghosts, that house was very cool. I mean, all hand-painted floors and the brick walls.
That was the old Shaker meeting house down there, which was where the Shakers first moved into Ohio. That was where they moved to.
The Shakers had some strange traditions, too, didn't
they? They did. They didn't believe in sex, I think.
Yeah, that's a little bizarre.
It was one of those crazy things. You wonder how they kept going. I
mean, they didn't. That's why they're gone.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Isn't that something?
You got to talk to me about this, David.
This is really interesting. I'm just going to sit back and let you
a couple more drinks and we'll be talking about all kinds of things.
We have to wait to put this on to later hour.
Seriously, I must mention, I'm going to be at Lorain County Community College on Thursday this week talking at the John Spitzer Center out there to a lot of the Lorain County libraries. You're going to be there.
Is there a chance we can buy one of your books, sir?
I hope so.
There you go.
I'll be very disappointed if there isn't.
Hey, one tank chest, we love them.
Thanks, Neil.
Thank you so much.
This one was a little spooky, but cool.
It was a bit spooky. Next week, we're going eating. Next time we go.
I like that idea.
Sounds good.
Hey, we're going to talk about something a little spooky, but not that spooky. Mm. It's Halloween fun, but it's called Boo at the Zoo, and this one's for the kids. It's at the Cleveland Metro Park Zoo, and it's great for the family. Little kids, big kids, kids of all ages. And you can dance at the Monster Mash, visit with the animals, and a whole lot more. And guess what? We have a family four-pack of tickets waiting for caller number 8, 216-578-0888. I think the tickets are $8, so those free tickets would be very cool to get. So good luck. Up next, discounted Halloween costumes. Yes, we'll be right back with some great costume ideas.
More of that and drink.